Today we can discuss the anatomy of monocot root. There is a primary structure of monocot root. In the last class we have discussed the primary structure of dicot root. So anatomically the monocot root has the following regions. They are epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, vascular bundles, conjunctive tissue and pith. So this is the epidermal region, and in between the epidermis and endodermis there is the cortical region, and this single layer is the endodermis, and within that you can see the pericycle region, and this is the vascular tissue, and this is the central region, pith region, and in between xylem and phloem this is the conjunctive tissue. And let's discuss in detail. First part is the epidermis. As you all know, it is the outermost protective layer. In root, the epidermis is otherwise called rhizodermis, epiblemma or piliferous layer, and it is made up of closely packed parenchyma cells. Here cuticle and stomata are absent. You can see that here unicellular root hairs are formed from the epidermal cells. In orchids, this epidermis is multiseriate, and this epidermal tissue is called velamen tissue, and the cells of this velamen are dead and compactly arranged so that it can absorb moisture from atmosphere, and that provides protection and reduce loss of water from the cortex. Next part is the cortex. It is the portion between epidermis and this endodermis or the vascular region, and monocot root has a well developed cortex, and it is made up of loosely arranged parenchyma cells mainly for storage function. And in some plants, some hypodermal cells or one or more subepidermal cell layers of the cortex may be thick walled and differentiated into a structure called exodermis. Subepidermal cells means it is a part of hypodermis, that is a specialized type of hypodermis that is called exodermis, and it contain lignin and suberin in their walls. These exodermis contain lignin and suberin depositions in their wall, and these exodermis is mainly prevent foreign pathogens and also prevent loss of water from the root system. So this is the dark colored part is the exodermis. In some plants we can, you can see that this structure exodermis after below the epidermis. Next is the endodermis. It is the innermost layer of the cortex. This is the endodermis, and it is a very prominent structure in roots compared to the stem, and it has a large barrel shaped cells, and it has special thickenings in the radial and tangential walls called Casparian thickening or Casparian strips. We have already discussed in the dicot root. And the endodermal cells opposite to the protoxylem remain thin walled and are called as passage cells. So this is the protoxylem, and the endodermal cells opposite to this protoxylem become thin walled, and these thin walled endodermal cells are called passage cells, and it allows radial conduction of water from cortex to the stellar region. Next is the pericycle. The pericycle lies below the endodermis, and it is made up of parenchyma cells. Next, the important region is the vascular bundles. Here vascular bundles in roots are arranged radially, that is the radial arrangement of vascular tissue, that is xylem and phloem. This is the xylem, in between you can see that this is the phloem, and xylem and phloem arranged in alternating radii, that is the radial arrangement, and the number of xylem strands equal to phloem strands. And here the in root the xylem is in XR condition, means protoxylem facing towards the periphery and metaxylem facing towards the central region, and metaxylem is circular in outline. So this is all about the vascular bundles. Next is the conjunctive tissue. It is the tissue, normal parenchyma tissue, which occupy between xylem and phloem. Okay, this is the cells which occupy between xylem and phloem, that is called a conjunctive tissue, and made up of closely packed parenchyma cells. In monocot root, this conjunctive tissue do not have meristematic activities, but in dicot roots it may possess meristematic activities. And in this monocot root, this conjunctive tissue provide mechanical support. Last region is the pith region or central region. It is the central part of the root, and it is made up of loosely arranged parenchyma cells. We can see that monocot root contain large pith compared to dicot root. In water plants, this pith may produce larger air cavities for their buoyancy. So these are all about the monocot root. Thank you for listening.